Thank you very much for joining us, Minister. So let me start by asking you, and I'm going to go in three parts. So first, I'm going to focus a little bit on your vision. The second part, I thought we'll focus a little bit about the nuts and bolts. You know, what is the status of the projects? I mean, you know, people sometimes are skeptical of the numbers. Why are they skeptical? What can you say to convince them otherwise? And then finally, let's talk a little bit about the future. So let's start with your vision. What do you think of, I mean, when you, you know, embark on the kind of ambitious projects and ambitious targets that you've been embarking on?
You are absolutely correct. I always say that you can donate eye, but you cannot donate vision. The lack of the vision is the is an important problem in the country. We have 52 lakh kilometer of road length available, out of which only 96,000 kilometer as a national highway, when I had taken a charge as a minister, now it changed. And 40% of the traffic is on national highway. Every year we are facing 5 lakh accidents and 1,50,000 deaths. So the reason for pollution, traffic jams, accidents is one of the reason is road engineering and road length. So my vision is to increase the national highway road length, and where I have taken a decision now recently within this 1.5 year, we have increased road length of national highway from 96,000 kilometer to 1,52,000 kilometer. And my target is up to the within 3 months, we will complete 2 lakh kilometers and then we close it, by which we will be succeed to 80% of majority traffic in the country on national highway. So that will save the pollution, traffic jam, and at the same time we can save the life of the people. That is one of the reason that construct more road, I feel, is more important than how we can save the life. So the first problem is, by increasing the road length, traffic will diversify and it will reduce the accident. The second important thing is, we have 30% bogus licenses in the country, driving licenses. It's very bad. India is the country where you can get easily driving license. So that is also one of the reasons for the accident. Regarding road engineering, somewhere we need flyover, some need underpass. Because of economic viability, there are a lot of mistakes from my department side. So we have taken a decision, if there is no position for it to make in PPP mode, we can make it from our own funds. So we have identified 726 black spots and the cost is 11,000 crores. And my department gave me the proposal that within 5 years we can rectify these black spots. I said no. You take all the works priority basis. If the problem is there, we will not construct more flyovers, but we have to remove the accidental spots first. So my vision is increase the road length, remove the reasons which are basically responsible in road engineering for accidents, and it's my target, just like road construction, at least, I don't know whether I will succeed or not, but at least 50% of the life of the people, which right. is a mission for me to save the life of the people. For
so
it.
Let me take a step back. So when we build roads, I mean, we all know that roads are good for the economy. I mean, America showed that great roads build great countries. What do you think of? I mean, why do we need to build so many roads? I mean, do we need to build so many roads? And how does it contribute to the larger economic and social transformation story?
Sir,
and from your perspective?
Sir, I have a statement of American President John Kennedy in my office, that American roads are not good because America is rich, but America is rich because American roads are good. I got appointed to make this Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. At that time I was minister in Maharashtra. And this one scheme, at that time, the report which is submitted to the Prime Minister is one scheme. If we make all concrete road or 100% connected to all villages, it will increase the GDP of 1,20,000 crore per year.
So only with connectivity?
Yes, because the prosperity and progress is the future. And the most important thing is, there are three important sectors, even in our GDP. First is service sector, where we have 50 to 54% of the GDP is from service sector. Then a manufacturing sector, that is industry, that is 20 to 24%. And 14% from agriculture, 12 to 14%. Now for agriculture, for industry, we need water, power, transport and communication. Without water, power, transport, communication, we cannot increase the growth rate. So if you want to eradicate poverty, if it is your mission, we have to increase the employment potential, particularly prioritized in the rural area, in agriculture sector, and by which we can eradicate the poverty. So the road sector is related with the progress and development of the country.
How do you relate it to the work you did in Maharashtra between 91 and 95 when you were PWD minister? So you did a lot of this. You actually built rural roads, you worked on policy, you worked on the execution side. Do you feel that it helped in raising Maharashtra's GDP?
It's a very interesting thing. I always say that if there is a strong political will, then you get the answer of every question. Once in a meet the press program in Pune, one of the senior journalists asked me that you are rejecting this proposal of Bombay-Pune Express Highway from a big industrial house. I reject that proposal because the cost quoted by 3,600 crores from Mumbai-Pune Express Highway. That was from Reliance. So I rejected that proposal. There was a lot of discussion, debate on that subject. So then you are going to construct it? Yes. What will your cost? You are estimating 2,000 crore. How much time it will take? 2.5 years. Then how much money you have? I say 10 crores. So they're all journalists, they just laughs. And Mr. Kardare, a renowned journalist from Pune, from Indian Express, was a senior man. He asked me the question, what you feel? You are coming, you are taking declaration. What you have? How you can say that you can make this road? I just simply say that if there is a will, there is a way. And if there is no will, there is only survey, discussion, seminar, committee, subcommittee and research group. So my strong political will is the asset for me. And fortunately, I raised 4,000 crores from the capital market. And within a two and a half year, we complete Mumbai-Pune Express Highway, 55 flyovers. I start the work of Worli-Bandra ceiling project. And the cost quoted by Reliance was 3,600 crore. And we complete that road by with 1,600 crore, 2,000 crore saving was there. And in flyover project, the cost, estimated cost on government 1,800 crore, we complete with 1,000 crore, 800 crore rupees saving is there. The Worli-Bandra project, half of the project completed at my time, but then the new government come and the project going from 420 crore to 1,800 crore.
But do you feel that, I sense that you seem to be arguing that the government is best placed to build roads?
No. I always have an opinion, today I'm in government. Government is proved to be the worst agency as far as the implementation is concerned. Jiska Raja Bepari, Uski Janta Bhikari. Government is not supposed to execute the projects. They are not supposed to run the railway and airports and roads because it is very difficult to implement the thing in government. Because everyone is responsible and no one is responsible. And there are different views on different level, and to make one view on it is very difficult task. But in a democratic system, we have no option. So we have to make our system transparent, time-bound, result-oriented, corruption-free. And this time-bound, result-oriented is a problem. So in government, the best policy for promotion is not taking decision. The officer who is not taking a decision, then his CR is very good because he's never taken any decision. That's why his case is fit for the promotion. But sometime what my feeling is, government is basically responsible to make the policies. And by appropriate policies and economic approach, we can make miracles. And there are a lot of people and talent is available. Now you just go, government start 5-star hotel, loss making. Government have gold mine, loss making. Government have power project, somewhere loss making.
Airline as well.
Airline is loss making. So we are not concerned with, I remember when I was a student, the phone call from Nagpur to Mumbai, the cost was 66 rupees. Now because of competition, I am getting 40 paisa only for that. Now Nagpur-Mumbai ticket at that time was 8,000 crore. Now we go by 2,200 crores. So if there is a more competition, more benefit to the consumer. So now we have to, the basic problem is we have to change our mind setup and our economic approach. Even in USA, they have liberal economic approach, they're capitalist. The China and Russia, they have left economy, they also collapse. Even socialism got succeed. So it is now time for the country to have appropriate economic policies by which we can eradicate the poverty, we can increase the more employment potential, and we can make the progress of this country, and we have to protect the interests of the poor people, those who are socially, economically, educationally backward. So this is the time to think about some new model on practical level which is going to be helpful for the poor people, downtrodden.
Right, but I mean, you mentioned railways and airlines. I mean, but the government is still running an airline. Government is still involved in managing airports and owning them. So maybe for roads, there is a sense of private participation, but I'm going to talk about that in a bit. But one doesn't get the sense that this government as a whole is embracing reform, at least in terms of, you know, letting go of businesses, letting go of doing business.
Already, reform is not a process where a single decision you can make the reform. It is a long-term process. Now, in my sector, the capability of the PPP project, even all contractors, all big companies, I don't take the name of them, they are all admitted in ICU. In one of the projects in my area, the leading company in the country, I just requested him that we are facing the election in Maharashtra. This is a prestigious project. Please, you do it. He said, no, please terminate me. I terminate that project. And that company's name is L&T. And the chairman come to me that we have decided now we are not going for any road project. Our board has taken a decision. Mr. Naik come to me and say, sorry, and he go. Today, the L&T is doing nine projects of 15,000 crores. They changed their decisions. And now the industry is changing. So I introduced the hybrid model.
So how did they change it? How did Mr. Naik change his mind?
Because when the thing moving fast, transparently, you just understand. 2.5 years, forest environment clearance, not a single file is cleared by the ministry. Land acquisition, big problem. Utility shifting, big problem. Litigation, how you can make the road? This type of environment, you cannot do anything. And we are facing the accidents, 5 lakhs accidents. And total road work as long as collapse. So we decided, we called contractors, officers, project to project, we make the study and research of it. And we find out the solutions. Only the difference is our approach was positive, transparent, time bound, result oriented. Now I just signed the contract of 1,50,000 crore. But I can confidently talk. No contractor never come to me. Because the reason is that the process was transparent. We have taken the fast track decision making process. We are solving the problem. And today, at that time when I taken charge as a minister, there was 384 projects, cost of 3,80,000 crores or stuck up project. Now 41 project we terminated. And now 80-90% of the problem already solved. Today, there was a pending of 21 project. Morning at 10 o'clock, I am meeting with my chairman and secretary. We have taken decision for 7 projects. And today, the balance project which are pending is only 14 project, cost 25,000 crore. And I am confident within the next month end, we will solve our 100% problem. And I can give you the accept your challenge. Anywhere in India, please tell me which road is now in problem.
Right, so I'm going to come to questions in a moment. Just one quick one before that. So when you say that 7 more projects were cleared this morning, do you mean that they've been signed off?
We find out the solution.
Okay. So it doesn't mean that work has actually resumed?
No, there was some problem, litigation. Somewhere in the interest of the project, you have to think out of box. Now there are two problems. Unfortunately, we are demoralized bureaucracy. If they've taken a decision, they are people, media, the other people asking why are doing it. If they are not doing it, everyone is happy. Now somewhere these are the system where there is a lot of hesitation for taking decisions. So I suggest my secretary, you call a meeting. Banker, contractor, chairman, secretary, all officers in the meeting, we meet. Sometime at night 12 o'clock our meeting was going on. We just ask him, giving the options and giving the solutions. And we record the minutes and then we taken the decision.
Okay, great. So let's get some questions. I'm going to collect a few questions and then come back. Yeah.
Honorable Minister, sir, you provided your vision according to social infrastructure, like congestion on roads and so many things. But in the wake of Make in India program by the Government of India and implementation of GST, the traffic flow is going to increase in the coming times. And what is the vision in the next 10 years or 20 years of the Government of India to expand the rural development? Because everything is determined by demand. Demand anticipation in the economy and industrial demand and the social demand. So is there any vision document anticipating road development in the next 10 years?
Right. So I'll collect a few more questions and then, yeah, go ahead.
So my name is Akash Jindal. I'm an economist. Now, you talked about out-of-the-box idea and roads are your passion, and I totally endorse that more the number of roads, it can be directly correlated with GDP growth. Now, when we talk about road, the issue comes about funding, and you just right now talked about funding. Now, in India, we all know we have been having a parallel economy. Now, of course, your government is driving towards 100% tax compliance, and it's good also. Though ideally, I should have asked this the finance minister, but since you are an important part of the government, what I want to know is, in case we have the black money which is in the system, I mean, the only sin is people didn't pay taxes. In case we can have an amnesty scheme like VDIS, and that money could be used for infrastructure, then the nice vision which you and your government have been having, that can be fulfilled, and people's money can be used for people's welfare. And going ahead, of course, we should target 100% compliance. And secondly, infrastructure bonds. Right now you are having infrastructure bonds where the interest is tax-free. But some years ago we had infrastructure bonds where the income which was invested was tax-free. So if we could have in this budget 50,000 for infrastructure bond, which is the income, the investment is tax-free, then people's money can be used for people's welfare. That money can be used for infrastructure, which would be good for social welfare as well as for development of GDP, right, which you have rightly said.
Okay, so we need to take a break on this, but you're watching Spotlight. We are going to be back in a minute. Stay with us. Welcome back. So I think we had more questions.
I'm KK Kapila, Chairman, International Road Federation. Sir, I have two submissions. We from the IRF have started a campaign to remove 10 black spots from each state as a priority. My submission is that we should try to have the next kilometrage which you are making at least free from these black spots. That's one part. Second, we should be able to request the members of parliament who can spend money from MP LAD into the road safety mayors should at least try to remove one black spot from each constituency. And if we do that, I'm sure we can remove all black spots within the next couple of years.
Right. Okay. Thank you. I'm going to come back to
one more thing which I want to add, sir. We would need some kind of ease of doing work, which is not there, particularly for the consultants in the profession. We are being paid. We are being made to pay service tax, even when we have not received payments. You had very kindly taken it up with the finance minister, but no results have come. I would strongly urge that in the coming budget, this problem should be solved.
Sir, you have absolutely very appropriate questions to a wrong person.
Because and free budget suggestions as well.
I am not the finance minister. And my habit is to concentrate on my work. I can give the answer of all these questions, but I am concentrating on my work. Regarding the black spot, you are absolutely correct. But there is no problem of money. It is unfortunate for me, it is a problem of mentality. In Maharashtra, when I was a minister, there was one committee under Mr. Tambe, who was the secretary, named as Apagat Nivaran Samiti. And we identified 2,500 accidental spots. So the money is there, but the social sensitiveness is very important. So I face a big accident. That's why I'm very much cautious about it. So your both suggestions are good. First off, there is national highway, state highway, district highways. So we have decided to, whatever the accidental spots on national highway, we will rectify. We have identified 726 spots, 11,000 crores, and my department gives the proposal for 5 years. I said, no, do it on priority basis. If you need it, don't construct more flyovers, but the first priority is to remove the black spots. Your second session is also good. Now I'm requesting state ministers to identify the spots and remove it. And there is an atmosphere now, where the state level, district level, municipal corporation, all are very cautious. And I am confident that in this 1-2 year, we can rectify all these black spots. Regarding the investment point of view, first I will tell you my economic plan. I don't need money. And you have to believe me, because I am the person who is in Maharashtra when I take 10 crores from the government 4,000 crores from the capital market and complete the work of 8,500 crores in 1998-2000. So first of all, I will give my plan. My budget is 45,000 crores. Probably for this budget, probably it may be increased by 15,000 to 20,000 crore I am expecting. So the budgetary support is good. Government has already given us a permission for 70,000 crores to raise tax exempted bonds, but we don't need it because we don't need money. The third is 101 projects are ready with me, with government money. I want to securitize that project where we will get at least 1,20,000 crore. Then my toll income is 10,000 crore. So I securitize this income for 15 years, I'll get 1,40,000 to 50,000 crores. Then lot of foreign investor ready to invest with me, and they are ready to give me loan with less than 2% on dollar. The hedging is my problem. So I'm finding out some mechanism for that, how to get it be cheaper. Because we want to reduce the cost and improve the quality construction. And land acquisition cost is now increased. So now most important thing for infrastructure is reduce the interest cost. And the interest cost is very important. So money is not the problem. My problem is my system is not working in that way what I expect from them. Now the time when I taken charge, I mean, was 2 kilometers per day. Now it is 18 kilometers per day. And up to March end, it is 30 kilometers per day. And my unofficial target is not for declaration for the media, but I am telling you was 100 kilometers per day. So we have got the resources available, but we have to change the system. We have to make system fast track decision making process.
There, what's the approximate cost per kilometer?
It is depending upon the, it is 2 lane, 4 lane, 6 lane, 8 lane. But I believe it comes to from 5 crores to 10 crores because we are all making now cement concrete road. And we have booked cement 95 lakh ton in our portal. The cost of cement is 120, 130 rupees, 140 rupees per bag, tax extra, cash and carry system. The market price is 300, 350 rupees per bag. Now we are planning that for dredging in the river because we have inland waterways program. So I am giving this proposal to all state government that we will make the dredging of the river with free of charge and we will collect that sand for road construction. And whatever the excess sand, you can make auction for that or you can use for the state government work. So that will reduce the cost. We are using the slag as a material in the steel industry that is available free of cost. So our approach is to reduce the cost of construction and improve the quality of construction. So now we are accepting international code. Indian code is conservative. So now the committee is appointed. We are within 2-3 days, I will issue the report. And by which we will make our standard code, which is standard to equivalent to international code. For flyover, for bridges, for other thing. Now our planning is to making 25 to 30 precast yard industries in the country, by which we are going to construct 250 railway overbridges, elevated roads. Even Delhi, the 40 kilometer diameter of Delhi, we are working. Our projects are costing more than 30,000 crores. So we can make the precast system, by which we can reduce the cost by 20-25% and improve the quality. So lot of good initiative which have already we have taken. That are very useful for the industry.
So I think there are 2 or 3 parts. I think so. There's land, there's labor, and there's capital. So you talked about capital. Now some of that capital also will have to come from banks. I mean, when you say that you don't have a problem of money, you're only talking about the government's contribution.
I'm telling you the factual position. 2 days before, there was a meeting in Vigyan Bhavan with all bank chairmen and finance minister to create the confidence in the mind of the bankers. So our secretary gave the presentation, this was the situation, this is we clear it. And now we introduce a new model that is called as hybrid model. And that is very good. The hybrid model is land acquisition 80% we will complete it. It is response of the department. Then we will see that all clearances for forest and environment, it will be response to the government. Then utility shifting also response to the government. And at the same time we will give them 40% as a subsidy grant. Or at a time of construction, by which he has to only invest 60%. So in 60%, 30% investment from his side and other investment from the bank. Then toll will be collected by the department. And on annuity basis, interest cost plus 3%, that profit we will give him. It's a very simple, very attractive scheme. and it taking good response. 28 projects are ready with me. We are already given four work order to four projects, and within end of the March, the project cost of 40,000 crores in hybrid mode, we will finalize.
What's the biggest project under this scheme?
But this is the Delhi to Meerut. There are three packages are there. From this NH24 start, we are making 14 lane roads. That's Swaminarayan Mandir in Delhi. And it will be 6 lane access control express highway. And it goes up to the Dasna. I'm sorry if missing, but I don't know Delhi, UP, anything. Because I don't know the geography about it. And Dasna, there is a green express highway to Meerut. Now, presently, Meerut to Delhi, it takes 3 hours, sometimes 4 hours. It will be only 40 minutes.
Okay, good. So let me get some questions and I'll begin with you. Go ahead. Yeah, introduce yourself.
Yes, I am Praveen Jha. I am a professor of economics at Jawaharlal Nehru University. Thank you, Minister, for your very interesting remarks and insightful ideas. Now, it appears to me that much of what you have said, the focus is really on highways and national highways. But as you rightly noted, the rural roads obviously are very, very critical in terms of adding to the welfare, to the income, GDP, and everything else. So one would like to hear a little more about that. Your example clearly shows that in several instances, government actually can do much better than the private sector. The example that you talked about in Maharashtra. Then why this skepticism about the government when it comes to, let's say, being a road builder and so on? And in general, you know, this whole issue of public sector that you were talking about, that again, I mean, your Navratnas and so on and so forth. I mean, there's a great deal there, a lot of, you know, very, very positive lessons and so on. So are you being somewhat sort of pessimistic for maybe not very good reasons? Thank you.
I am not socialist, capitalist, and communist. I am very practical. Okay. Out of 100 stories, the 10 stories are successful and 90 stories are fails. So that's on my practical experience I am talking it. Now, you are absolutely correct that in present time, I feel that we have to increase the speed, the growth rate is very important. And for that purpose, we have to involve lot type of people, investment, where we can increase the growth rate. So that is one of the reasons that we can encourage the public-private partnership. But I will tell you now, when I taken charge as a minister, there are lot of PPP project, no one responds, because the industry, there was not any position to bid that project. So we introduced the hybrid model. So there are a lot of innovations and new technologies available, and we can use it. And as far as my approach is concerned, because of you are from Jawaharlal Nehru University, I am to clarify it. Now this is the time for the country, you are the base judge. By whatever you write on the books, on the economic thinking which is in the books, on that basis you cannot build the new future of this country. I want to suggest you, that whether it is communist, socialist or capitalist, something we have to find out new solution, which is going to make more employment potential, which will protect the interests of the poor people, and at a time, you are absolutely correct for rural infrastructure. Though I am working as a minister here, but I am concentrating my work on my rural area, and I am giving employment to 15,000 youth. But this Delhi and this politics and your atmosphere, some people call me as a businessman. I'm not a businessman. I got the ability to make a business. My IQ's cost is more than 200 crore rupees per month. But as deliberately, I'm doing social service for the poor. I'm running 1100 Ekal Vidyale in the Naxalite belt of Gadchiroli and other area. My problem is that you are absolutely correct. These Delhi people, either they are in government, either they are in politics, either they are in media, or either they are in university, they understand the problem of India, but they can't understand the problem of Bharat. The rural, agriculture, economy problems are very serious. You are absolutely correct. And one thing I want to admit it, it may be a contradiction. Those who are creating more pollution, the road sector creating more pollution, more imports, more accidents, we are paying them more big budget. Just I give you the example. In waterways, 47% of traffic in China is goods and passengers have gone water. 44% in Korea and Japan, and more than 40% in European countries. If the cost of You consider, suppose for example, is 1 rupees 50 paisa for road, then 1 rupees for railway, and 25 paisa for waterways. Our waterways, goods and passenger traffic percent only 3.5%. And what is the policy of the government is, the waterways where we need to give highest priority, there is a budget of 1,000 crore. And the road sector, which creating more pollution, more accident, they have a budget of 45,000 crores. And those who are creating more pollution, more accident, they are getting big budget. And those who can save the country, they are getting the less budget. I am the minister for road, and I am the minister for ports, and I am the minister for island waterways. Everything is with me. But we need to change our approach for that. I am constantly pursuing that, give priority to waterways. I am making Ganga, you know, Mahanadi, Brahmaputra, and even in media people, it's my dream project, I'm doing it. They are not very much interested to think about these waterways and coastal shipping and other thing. Today, this is the first year in the history of India that our all 12 major ports and 3 flagship organizations, Shipping Corporation of India, Dredging Corporation of India and Cochin Shipyard, where our profit will be more than 6,000 crore. And I'm investing that profit in inland waterways. And my turnover in all these ports is in dollar is 4,000 crore. And my idea is I can take 50,000 crores of loan with less than 2% interest in dollar. And I'm going to invest that money into inland waterways. But I'm trying, giving priority, always trying, but no one is going to listen to me about waterways because everyone is talking of the roads. This is Delhi. I'm a newcomer for Delhi. I'm a straightforward, transparent man. It's difficult for me to understand. But I don't know anything. My ideas are clear. My conviction is fixed, and my path is very clear. So I am going to do it the more priority for waterways, inland waterways, coastal shipping, and it's my dream. It is a very difficult task. I don't know whether I will succeed or not. But this regime, I am going to concentrate on it. In Ganga, we are making 3 multimodal hub at Varanasi, Haldia, and Sahibganj. And before March, we are going to start that work. Already we have started the export of fly ash from Farakka to Bangladesh. Huge potential is there. But somewhere I will request you that in place of road, take more discussion on waterways and living. It will give a good idea to the people, which is very much in the interest of the country. The idea is, with the help of World Bank, the success story, we are taking the consultancy from the people from the world, and we are making 3 meter of draft without constructing any barrages in Ganga. Already Farakka is there. So within 6 months, I will show you the picture. My idea is to take seaplane, water plane on the Ganga, catamaran, hovercrafts, the cruise. It's very attractive for tourism. For the fish also, the fishermen also, it's useful. There's a huge potential. In our country, our 13 states and 14,000 kilometer area is related with our coastal areas. The seafront is there. The riverfront is important. And everywhere in the world, you go into any country, all industries side to riverfront, because their logistic cost is less. So somewhere we have to change our mind setup, and we have to think out of box, and we have to give the priority for the sector where we need. Ethics, economy, ecology, and environment, 3 things are very important. As far as ecology is concerned, economy is concerned, we need the system which import substitute, cost effective, and pollution free. So I feel that waterways.
Let me interrupt you there. I think we've got lots of questions. Let's get some more questions in. Yeah.
Yeah. My name is Pinaki Chakraborty. I work at National Institute of Public Finance and Policy. Sir, until I heard you, I thought your ministry is responsible for the government to say that we are going to increase the fiscal deficit because we have to spend a lot on infrastructure. But after your comments on the resource position saying that you don't need money, so I'm not really clear.
And actually, the one factor there, the finance minister is giving me the money. There are 2 things that are there. One is the toll collection, that is my money. And the second is, there is surcharge on petrol and diesel. And there is already, it is defined that it is mandatory for the finance minister to give me. So this, by adding these 2 amount, my 40,000 will come from that. So somewhere you people, economists, interpret as that finance minister giving highest priority to the infrastructure, it is correct. But out of the 40,000 is my legitimate claim, and other is this is giving from this finance ministry.
And you said that there could be an increase of possibly 15 to 20,000 crore for the budget 2015-16.
Crude oil rate is now reducing. That's why there is a chance for him to give me the more money.
Sir, other issue that I just wanted to ask you, sir, what is your priority?
But one thing I want to clear it. that finance minister is very clear and is sincerely from the first day. He has a strong conviction to give highest priority for infrastructure. So he is very much positive about it.
Sir, other issue is, by nature, PPP or the hybrid model could be very iniquitous for the country because there is a process of money return involved. So I was just thinking, what are your ministry's priority with regard to the backward regions of the country, especially the Northeast, with regard to investment in the next couple of years that you are talking about?
Mr. We'll just take one or two more questions and we need to go in for a break as well. Last question, we're going to a break and then we'll come back. Yeah, go ahead.
Thank you. It was very nice to listen to you and know your vision and plans, and I really commend you upon that. My name is Renu Kohli and currently I'm an independent economist. I've previously worked with the Reserve Bank and the IMF. I had two questions. One is, there are obviously budgetary constraints upon the EPC model of financing and spending upon roads and infrastructure investments. So you've come up with this hybrid annuity model, and as we can see from the rise in the shares of the infrastructure firms 2 days ago, it's been rather well received. So two questions, which is, one is that what is your plan to revive the private sector interest to bid for these projects under this hybrid annuity model, considering you just yourself mentioned that they have been, the firms are in the ICU, and even as recently as last week, from the ICU, many of them are onto the graveyard also. You know, there is this issue of Gammons India just slipped into the black last week. The second thing is to do with the financing implications under the hybrid annuity. The sharing is 40-60. But what is the plan the government has or the ministry has for, these are after all the returns that will be paid for by the government are eventually going to devolve upon the government. This is a deferred payment, as it were, and there are future fiscal liabilities. Whether they will be taken onto the public balance sheet straight away or they will be accumulate as off balance sheet items. So what is the plan about that?
Okay, so we need to take a break on that, and we'll come back after a break and resume on Spotlight with the Honorable Minister Nitin Gadkari. Stay with us. Okay, welcome back. You're with Spotlight, and we're talking to the Union Minister for Roads, Transport and Shipping, Mr. Nitin Gadkari. Mr. Gadkari, I think we had a couple of questions which are quite interesting. The first one was on what is your priority for the Northeast, and then we'll come to...
Sir, I am the first person in the country who started the first PPP road. When I was minister, my idea. And the first Thane-Bhiwandi pass was the road. Once I want to clear it, the inspiration behind PPP model, I'm very clearly telling you, politically, I am from a backward area of Maharashtra. And in Mumbai, there was a traffic density was high. So I was interested to divert my budget to my area. That's why I taken the all flyovers in Mumbai Express Highway with PPP model with private investment. And I concentrate my all budget to the village connectivity. And I connect 16,000 villages of Maharashtra because that I save the money and give that to the rural sector. So my inspiration and motivation behind private-public investment was giving more priority to rural, poor and agriculture sector. The second thing is, as far as the money is concerned, I want to tell you, we are starting this PPE, this hybrid mode is not because of our financial constraint. Madam, I don't have any financial constraint. To be very frank and fair, my problem is with my system. I can make 100 kilometers of day per day. But my problem is I want to make my system, my capacity building in my system to be need for my department to make it more strong. So it is because of the present situation of the contractors and the investors. Because one fact is very clear that majority investor and contractors, you have to take a name of all these companies, they are familiar to me, they are collapse. And they collapse because land acquisition problem, litigations, negative approach of the government, forest environment clearance, railway overbridges clearance. In railway, for one railway overbridge, for clearance, it takes 3 years. I was very angry with the railway chairman. I used some words for him. And within a week, 75 railway overbridges cleared by railway and start an online system. So not taking decision was a problem. That's why the industry is facing the problem. I'm very frank and fair. The 80% problem, not contractor and investors are responsible, the government was responsible. It is not good for me to say this, but I am always talking bluntly. If it is true and correct, I don't hesitate to talk about it. It is the negative approach of the system, that's why they are facing the problem. So that's why for public-private investment, we have chosen this model, that is hybrid model. In the model, you just understand, the toll will be collected by my department. And on annuity basis, we are giving only them bank interest plus 3% profit, so other income will be our. So it is a transparent system. And so that's why, because of 40% at the time of the starting the road construction, they are getting the 40% subsidy in that. They are getting grant in aid for that. So that's why it is easy for banker to give finance. No, second problem. In Indian scenario, the Indian bankers are coming in such a position that we don't want to finance infrastructure. Many of the bank chairmen meet me, I'm sorry, this type of NP is there. So we have to step by step improve the system. We clear the problems of the projects. Now the banks are happy. Basically, you call any chairman of the banker or MD, he can tell you the ground reality story. So now today I request them in my meeting 2 days before in presence of finance minister. Now don't bother, be secure, be positive and finance. Now it's a good thing, no problem, please finance. I will make them request for that. And now today they are financing.
So it is
because of the contractors, not because of the customer. As far as government is concerned, whatever the financial today which is available with me, I can make too much roads. There is no problem about it.
Yeah, but just one question on, I mean, you talked about
and regarding
tolls,
this rural connectivity, you are absolutely correct because I am the responsible person who prepared that Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. But we need more money for that. And the situation is not good. And we should give highest priority for rural connectivity. So for this year, I am pursuing to the finance minister. If you want, you can subtract some amount from my budget, but give it more to the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana. And probably this year, probably Prime Minister will give the priority for that. And it is really an important issue and heart of the subject. And my opinion is government should give highest priority for that, for rural connectivity.
You had a question on the Northeast as well, right?
Northeast, we have already given, sanctioned the projects of 1 lakh crores. And out of which 20,000 crore project already have been started. And within my 5 years, I am not that type of politician that no journalist can ask me any question about my commitment. I am talking responsibly. I am talking means it's, I will do it. I am very much sensitive about Northeast. And already I have a sanction. We have formed a new corporation, a National Highway Road Construction Corporation for Northeast. Our separate office is there. And I am confident that in this 5 year, we will complete the work of 1 lakh crores. And we will, that is definitely going to change the socio-economic scenario of Northeast. We are already started the work, sanctioned the work of 40,000 crore in Arunachal Pradesh, in Manipur, in Tripura, in Assam already, there are 40,000 crores of work already sanctioned in Assam. And they need more good infrastructure for their development. So we have a highest priority for Northeast and we are going to do it.
Right, so more questions, yes.
I represent SOCHM and my name is SK Jindal. I wish to know your plan for handling or resolving this issue of system, 80% problem which you have from the system. Second, when can we see that we don't have to ask these questions to you and you don't have to reply them and we can see for ourselves that things are happening in a good way? We have conviction, what you have said, very enlightening and very satisfying. But when do you think we'll be able to see them and we don't have to ask you, sir? Okay.
Sir, in my department, there was 1890 Act, 1890 ka kaida tha, 1905 ka tha. Maine aise ek din sab act ikatta kiye aur daba ke secretary ke haath mein diye aur jaate samay dustbin mein fek do karke kaha. Aur pure abolish kiye, the director of shipping ke aage committee appoint ki. Ab unhone ek hi act banaya hai. और वो एक्ट अभी लॉ मिनिस्ट्री से आया है, अभी कैबिनेट में अप्रूव होगा. मैंने बहुत से नोटिफिकेशन कैंसिल कर दिए और मैंने कहा सबमिट करो, हटाओ इसको, ये वर्मी कल्चर करने के लायक है, फेंको इसको. और ये इतने गवर्नमेंट में रूल्स और रेगुलेशन ऐसे बनाए हुए क्योंकि काम ही नहीं कर सकता. हाथ बांधो, पैर बांधो, दौड़े क्यों नहीं करके सवाल पूछो. तो ये मैंने अपने डिपार्टमेंट तक कुछ किया, बाकी डिपार्टमेंट में लोग कर रहे. प्राइम मिनिस्टर भी बार बार सेक्रेटरीज की मीटिंग बुलाकर चेंजेस कर रहे हैं. पर ये बहुत कठिन विषय है. इट इज़ नॉट ए इजी सब्जेक्ट. इट विल टेक सम टाइम फॉर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव रिफॉर्म. और एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव रिफॉर्म नेवर स्टार्ट फ्रॉम ब्यूरोक्रेसी. इट स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम द पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप And I personally accepted that it is the responsibility of the political leadership to make administrative reform. And that is the most important thing for our country, is very important.
My name, sir, is Jamal Ansari. I am a town planner. I have two very small questions. Number one is about Eastern and Western expressway around Delhi. I want to know, aapke paas kya jadoo hai aisa, ke project which was lingering for last 12 years, you proposed to complete it within 400 days, the timeline. The second question is, small question, is about the inland waterways. I remember 1.5 years ago when you became a minister, you said that you are going to make this Yamuna River in Delhi navigable. Is there a timeline for that? Thank you very much.
Okay, one more quick question because we're running out of time as well. Yes.
I'm changing the topic a little bit. 17th March last year, we met you for one major concern of the engineering profession, that we have no legislative backing. It is the only major profession which doesn't have, every other profession has. And you kindly helped us and you wrote immediately a letter to the Ministry of HRD, Minister of HRD. But unfortunately, nothing has happened. We, the engineering profession, is facing a major problem, and you are spending a lot of money on the projects which where engineers are involved. And for the safety of the society and everybody, it's important that the qualified engineers participate in this. No. Can we propose you to be a godfather for engineers to somehow get this legislation passed in the parliament?
Let me get a quick question in. Yeah.
Okay, for the last 1.5 years, for all the proposals coming from the government, the private sector has been playing coy and defensive for various reasons. They are not stepping out and say that we will do it. Right. What is the real problem? How are you going to convince them?
Last question, yes, go ahead.
Minister, thank you so much for talking to us, and it's heartening to see that there is a movement on the national highway construction and road construction. There is one positive suggestion that I would like to make. There is a problem that still persists, and that problem is that many of the disputes in construction industry are totally lying unresolved. Now, what we need to do is to get away from the ad hoc mode of arbitration processes that we were following. Suggestion is invite all the stakeholders, like you have been doing in past, and basically see that within a limited time-bound manner, the whole thing is resolved. This is going to ease out the bankers, bring back the confidence, and also give enough resources to contractors to really get on the way.
Right. Okay. So we've completely run out of time, except for 2 minutes for you to respond to whichever question you want, and then we'll close.
Your suggestion is correct. It is a very difficult question with relate to the finance ministry and law ministry. I am trying for that. Still, there are 4,000 cases are there. I don't get, I'm trying to solve this problem, but I'm trying for that. But today, I don't have any correct answer for your question.
So, you have a question on the Delhi.
Sir, I will take it. The other questions related with Yamuna, I can't give any line because my bill is pending from last 4 months in the parliament. Parliament has already passed the bill. The Rajya Sabha is not taking the bill. If I can get succeed to be passed in Rajya Sabha, I will start immediately working in Yamuna. Regarding this externally express and other thing, I constantly pursuing this matter. Matter was in Supreme Court, the Burilal committee was there. But today all problems have been solved. The Prime Minister given me the target for 400 days. I am not sure whether we will complete it or not, but we are trying for that and the work is now start.
So let me ask you a last
And regarding question. The private investment, my department don't have any problem. People are now very active and they are positively interested to invest in the road projects. So your suggestion is good. I will try to do it.
Okay. So last question, Mr. Gadkari, before we close. I think I said that, you know, how do we look at the future? So we've talked about current. You've talked about your backlog. You've talked about the challenges that you're facing. The question is, how do you look at the future and what kind of vision do you see, you know, 10 years, 20 years down the line for India?
I feel that the future is good.
In the context of transport?
Yes. I will talk about in the context of economy and transport. At that time, Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji taken charge as a Prime Minister. Our GDP was 4.5%. Now it is 7.5%. I only talk about my department because it will not be appropriate to talk for another department. But my target is increase the GDP of 2% and creating jobs for 50 lakhs people. When 1 crore rupees of investment is there, it creates 800 jobs. So I'm more interested to creating more jobs. I am interested to how we can stop these accidents, black spots, improving of black spots.
And I feel that for the road construction, other things are moving fast. I don't need to advocate all this work because you can, it is visualized, you can easily see. And this is the time for the country to develop the good infrastructure of international standard by which we can be competitive in international market and where we'll be increase more export. And that is going to be a change the economy of our country. I am trying, as far as my sector is very restricted up to roads, shipping, ports, and inland waterways. These are my sector, and I have a habit. My concentration is only in my work. I am not concerned with the other subject. So I am responsible for my ministry. I am doing from morning 8 to at night to work with my ministry. I am not going to think about the other problem. I don't have good liaising with media. Neither I'm going to bother about anybody. I know my work. I'm doing it. It is a difficult task. I'm not sure what will happen. But I have confidence that these 5 years will be very remarkable and historical for infrastructure of India. And whatever the work which we will contribute, it will be more than what the work contributed in the last 50 years.
Mr. Gadkari, we run out of time completely. Thank you so much. That's all we have time for in this special edition of Spotlight, coming to you from the Ethiraj Hotel. Thank you so much for watching.